Many, many years ago, before your great-great-grandparents were even born, there sat a tiny little acorn high up on a hill. Now, this was a happy little acorn, and with good reason. The snow which had covered him all winter long had finally melted. Spring was on the way. Now, a short distance away from the little acorn, overlooking the valley, stood a strong old oak tree. The tree had beautiful branches that reached to the sky. The little acorn said to the tree, "I hope someday I can grow into something as magnificent as you." Slowly responding with the wisdom of many years, the tree replied, "You will, as long as you are patient. It will take a long time through many seasons, but you are in the right conditions to take root and become a fine oak tree someday." Excited at these words and overcome by the beauty of the sun-bathed hilltop, the little acorn shouted, "What a wonderful place to grow!" "It could be better," said a voice. Startled, the little acorn asked, "Who said that?" "I did," said the crow perched on the big rock, "and you could find a much better place to grow." "What do you mean?" asked the acorn. "Once I grow above the grass, I have a wonderful view. Perhaps, however, this is a small hilltop. I've flown all over this country, and there are prettier places than this," the crow replied. "My home, for instance, is even higher than this hill. It's a rocky crag high in that mountain off in the distance. From there, you could see everything. Do you want me to fly you up there?" The little acorn thought out loud, "Well, it would be nice to have a better view once I'm a tree." But the old oak tree interrupted. "Wait, little acorn. Think about this for a second. Once the snow melts up there, you'll only find dry, rocky ground. But my roots have reached water deep beneath us. This place is where you need to be in order to grow." Considering this, the little acorn said, "No, thank you, crow. I think I'll be fine right here." And with that, the crow flew away. And time moved on. And with it came the rainy season. As the first few drops of water splashed on the little acorn, he happily exclaimed, "Now I'll begin to grow." "Are you sure that's a good idea?" boomed a voice. Confused, the little acorn asked, "Who said that?" "I did," replied the big dark thundercloud. "Are you sure you want to grow there?" "Well, I thought so," said the acorn. "What's wrong with this hilltop?" "Oh, it's a fine hilltop," assured the cloud. "But there's so much more of the world that you could see. For instance, you've never seen the oceans. I could send my rain in just the right way to wash you down the hill into the river. Soon you'd be carried out to the sea. You really should see it. It's a beautiful sight." "That sounds amazing," exclaimed the little acorn. But the old oak tree stopped him. "Hold on, little acorn. You need soil to take root. There's no soil in the ocean. You'd be tossed around and would never become the tree you were meant to be." Considering this, the little acorn said, "No, thank you, Thundercloud. I think I'll be fine right here." And with that, the big dark thundercloud's rain pushed the little acorn a little deeper into the soil. Time moved on. And soon the sun came out again. Half buried in the dirt, the acorn excitedly shouted, "Hooray! Now my roots will begin to grow!" "Not so fast," a squeaky voice called out. Bewildered, the acorn asked, "Who said that?" "I did," replied the gray squirrel. "And don't sink your roots in just yet." "Why not?" asked the acorn. "It's about time I started to grow into a tree." "Oh, sure, sure," replied the squirrel with a hungry look in his eye. "But squirrels are good at burying things. I could take you somewhere else, say, closer to where my family lives. We found a cozy little cave to make our home. I could bury you there. Who knows, maybe you'll grow faster once I've buried you deeper." "Well, it would be nice to be placed deeper in the soil. Maybe that's what I need," thought the little acorn. "Please, little acorn," pleaded the oak tree, "be careful. First of all, a cave has no sunlight. You would never have the light you need to grow. And secondly, I don't think that squirrel intends to really help you." Considering this and feeling slightly uneasy with the way the squirrel was staring at him, the little acorn said, "No, thank you, squirrel. I think I'll be fine right here." And with that, the gray squirrel scampered off to find another acorn to help. Time moved on. The months became years. The acorn stood his ground through the howling wind, the beating rain, the scorching sun, and the icy snow. The little acorn had now become a strong young tree. His branches were full with beautiful leaves. Standing beside him, Overlooking the valley, the old oak tree slowly spoke to him. I've watched you grow up to be a magnificent tree. I'm glad that you were patient and never gave up on the soil and the sunlight and the water that were right here for you all through the years. Before the young tree could respond, a crow landed on the ground next to a tiny acorn. Hey there, little acorn. Do you want me to fly you somewhere else? I could find a much better spot for you to grow. The strong young tree said to the acorn, Wait a second, tiny acorn. Trust me. The conditions for you to grow are perfect right here on this hilltop. You just have to be patient. Disappointed, the crow flapped its wings and flew away. The new little acorn sat between the wise older tree and the strong younger oak tree, and time moved on.